there's a lot of people who invented new things and sounds and whatnot. I mean, you can listen to Jimi Hendrix and you know that he had a signature sound. You can listen to Edward Van Halen and know that he had a signature sound. You can listen to Frank and know that he has a signature sound, but it's usually too bizarre for anybody to go, well, I could do that. You know, it's, you hear it and you go, that's cool, but I don't know what the hell it is. When I'm trying to play a solo or something, I hear mostly what I'm doing, and I hear a vague notion of the backbeat, you know, but he was able to hear everything that was going on from every instrument and complement it in whatever fashion he wanted, and he would call his guitar solos air sculptures. Gone are the days of getting a bunch of great musicians in a room and having them play versus, like, now it's, hey, let's have the drummer play to a click track and don't worry about it. We'll fix it in Pro Tools after the fact. In fact, we won't even use any of the kit that we recorded because we're going to trigger the ones from the sound effects library that we have that's really cool, you know. So it has nothing to do with anything anymore. Now it's, you know, there are great advancements in technology that help people, but it's also detrimental because now you have guys that can't play at all who think they're really bitching because the producer made them sound good, and the kids who buy the records don't know any better either.
Working in a band, whether it be Frank Zappa or Miles Davis or Cannonball Adderley or whatever it is, by missing that band experience, they're missing out on that contact with these musicians who can impart a lot of information. I mean, there's a lot of information that guys my age could impart to somebody that's very young. The same thing was with Frank. Frank was obviously older than me, and he imparted so much information for me that I could not get from a record. If I had not worked with Frank in that setting, I would not have the knowledge I have now.
Merry-go-round, merry-go-round, do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
And they called that doing their thing.
Oh, yeah. That's what doing your thing is.
The thing is to put a motor in yourself.
Playing bike, Frank?
About 2 weeks.
He probably was selling insurance or something, and he thought, what's something real jerky that'll get me on the Steve Allen show? Playing bicycle, what could be sillier than that? And he did it, and here we are. That's probably how it happened. You really only been playing 2 weeks?
Yes.
What do you do ordinarily besides this?
I'm a composer.
Ah. Might we be familiar with any of your songs as yet?
Well, you will be familiar with some of my songs as of next week, but I did the score for The World's Greatest Sinner. The...
and who might that be? Tommy Manville or who? Tell us about that.
That's the name of the film. It's the world's worst movie, and I did the music for it.
The World's Greatest Sinner?
Yes.
I was for the job of the moment. You want to play the New Departure Blues, or exactly what are you going to lay on us here? I'll just let you show us what happens.
The first thing that I should do is demonstrate to you the different types of sounds that you can get from a bicycle, because it actually does make some very interesting sounds, and of course that's what we're all interested in.
Is new sounds, yes. Like bah, 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 bah.
One of the sounds that you can get.
Yes.
The way we work this is, when the man in the control booth feels moved to add his electronic part to our work here, he will throw a little switch, which just lets some of this noise through, and then I request of the musicians that if they feel so moved, make any noise possible on your instrument. No, try and refrain from musical tones. And in fact,
they won't have any trouble with that order.
If it would be possible for you
the regular way, fellas. I'm sorry.
If it would be possible for you to put some sort of objects on the strings of the piano, you'll get... That's good. I prefer you to play it that way.
All season long, Don.
Now, we'll start.
Are we on?
He wrote for us, especially for the Ensemble Inter Contemporain, he wrote three short pieces, and we performed these pieces in a concert where I confronted him on purpose with Elliot Carter and Charles Ives and some other American composers, but you know, the one we are called intellectual, let's say. And I wanted especially to show that I did not take Zappa just, you know, on the side, but I wanted to put him in the middle.
The composition end of my musical experience started in high school when I heard an album by Edgar Varese. And I said, boy, that sounds great. I have to write some of that.
He was very much aware of what he wanted, and I think that's an exception in this milieu, I mean, of pop music, so let's say, that he was not one of them, only he was an exception.
J'ai dit très très souvent, si nous prenons la chaîne de la tradition, il ne faut pas confondre tradition avec 20, 30 ou 40 ans de mauvaises habitudes. Ça, c'est pas ça la tradition. Les gens qui sont devenus des classiques de par fonction du temps, c'est-à-dire qu'ils étaient de leur temps, les gens étaient en arrière. C'était difficile pour eux, ils n'étaient pas comprendre. Les gens qu'on appelait des gens qui étaient avant leur temps, c'est pas vrai, ou en avance de leur temps. C'est-à-dire qu'ils étaient de leur temps. Ces gens-là ont cristallisé leur temps, on connaît leur temps de par ces gens-là qu'on disait en avance de leur temps. Seulement, les autres, comme les gens sont toujours plutôt en retard, la génération qui suit, alors, c'est nouveau la génération où si un homme nouveau arrive, il dira qu'il est en avance de son temps.
I don't think they understand either.
What, the smoke?
The band.
The band doesn't understand what?
Do you know that?
The smoke stands still.
There's some kind of thing that's giving us all these revelations.
Yeah, that's the...
It's this funny voice. And he keeps telling us all these things. And I just thought that before we just thought of these things. You know, like just off the wall and out of our heads.
No, that's religious superstition.
Most of the things that I heard Frank say really were of older ideas that were sort of moved into the computer age. He had pointed out, like the Klangfarben example, that the computer had really made possible the concepts that were developed by the serial composers in Vienna. In the synclavier, instead of thinking of a note as one entity, it has parameters, the start time, the duration, the pitch, the loudness, all of these things are completely independent elements, and it's very easy to just have a list of pitches totally independent from a list of rhythms, and that really makes possible this notion of applying rows.
He was disappointed with a lot of experiences he had with classical orchestras, ensemble musicians, and also he, with the synclavier, he had the ultimate instrument. He just could try out ideas without, you know, waiting for somebody to practice. So it's both. It's on one hand it's a compositional tool, and on the other hand it's a performance tool. He was very happy with the ensemble. They would be willing to try out really hard pieces which he was composing the synclavier.
They contacted him to write a piece for the ensemble, and you know that turned into this amazing opportunity. When Frank had, you know, he was so ill at the time, but no one knew then how progressive his illness would be in such a short time, and when he thought he was debilitated then, it was nothing compared to how debilitated he was when he did the Varese project later through the ensemble Moderne's auspices and help, you know. But that program in 92, he had the opportunity to work with them as a band, you know.
Keep up the great work. I don't know what to pierce next. P.S. Do you use 1% xylocaine for deep cock head piercings? Piercing the head of the cock must be painful.
Oh.
I had the head tattooed and it hurt like hell.
And he was just very, very happy. And I think it was a big present that the musicians gave him to play that music and try really hard to make it work. Long rehearsal days, long rehearsing period compared to other classical orchestras. I mean, he was used to very, very long rehearsals with his band, you know, 3 months, 12 hours a day, but classical world, it's quite different. Was trying to do things about the rooms and ambiences. He was doing a pointillistic piece, America, and was distributing a line, which is like a line going like that into all the different instruments in the ensemble, which is really hard to play. And he wanted every little bit with a different color, so everybody has a little bit of freedom to form the notes. So it's like a patchwork which you can hear.
So, das hat die Basis. Ja. So, dann nochmal von vorne.
Einfach nochmal zum Hören. Also nicht so lassen. Aber die Celesta ist schon wichtig, dass die Celesta klingt.
Ah, finde ich wunderbar, das
Klavier. Ja, lieber das Klavier lassen.
Und weniger besorgt, sozusagen. Go. One, three.
See him standing in that typical classical context. I always think that he's his own planet, his own world, which touches the classical world, which touches the rock world, which touches the film world. It's his own, he stands off for himself, you know.
Classical musicians sometimes are buried in our repertoire. We don't look beyond these limits and these limitations. And therefore, I think as I mean to meet people like Zappa was for me challenging because, you know, I penetrated a world I did not know at all. And of course, you take what you want and you take what is useful for you and you follow.